In this part, we're going to implement switch to change the app theme into dark or light mode using Flutter BLoC. If you are new on this channel, hit the subscribe button. Hi there! We are glad to see you in this part. Please, like the tutorial to support our hard work and for more people to see this video. Before implementing switch in our app, I want to teach you one more important thing. Here, in the drawer, change the screen several times. We used the push named in the navigator, this means that the screens are stacked on top of each other. And when you press back button, screens will go backward one by one. Collecting many screens in the stack is just kind of memory consuming, and we don't need the screens in the stack. So, we use push replacement named instead of push named. This push replacement named replaces the first screen into the second. So, that means there always be only one screen. Again, change the screen several times. After that, press back button and it leaves the app. That means we don't have many screens on top of each other. Now, let's implement switch in the drawer. For a while, make this value false and leave unchanged empty. And here, our switch, but now it doesn't work. Before implementing BLoC for the switch, let's activate it with stateful widget for a while. Because when we press the switch, it changes its state, so we need stateful widget. Create a variable for switch value. Set it as a value. And here, in setState, we update value by the value of switch callback. Let's test it. It's working perfect. Now it's time to implement switch BLoC. Before it, change this BLoC folder name into tasks BLoC. And change it here to get rid of the errors. And we create another new BLoC for the switch. Just name it switch. And also, change this folder name. Finally, in the BLoC exports, export this switch BLoC. Save and close the exports file. Now, let's implement switch BLoC state. As you see in the example of switch that we activated, we need switch value. And make named constructor. Insert switch value into the props. And in the initial class, create constructor to call superclass. Finally, delete the abstract keyword. Next, go to switch event. And here we'll create two events. First, switch on event. And second, switch off event. Next, go to switch BLoC. Here, initialize switch initial state, which is false. And now, it emits new switch state according to different switch events. On switch on event, it emits new switch state with true value. And on switch off event, it emits new switch state with false value. Switch block is ready. Next, we create AppTheme class. It will be a big class. That's why we had a better create it in a different file in the services. For not consuming much time, I copy and paste the theme class details. Here in the dark and light theme, all elements are chosen one by one by AG Flutter team and tested whether it suits or not the project. And this app theme class took us almost one day to test everything, such as colors, floating action button theme, text button theme, and so on. You can download it through the link in the description and create enum for the app theme. In enum, we'll have light theme and dark theme. So our app theme class is ready. Now go to main class. First of all, we have two blocks, task block and switch block. So we must use multi-block provider. Just add the word multi and delete the single block provider. And insert providers list. First, task block. And second, switch block. And now go to my drawer. Here we implement switch block. Wrap the switch with block builder. Change the value into state switch value. And here we no longer need set state, so delete it. And instead, according to the new switch value, we add switch on event or switch off event. And also, convert stateful widget into stateless widget. Wrap the material app with switch block. Then, according to the switch value, we change the app theme into dark or light mode. Let's test it. It's working perfect. Now, we use hydrated block to save the app theme state in the local memory. By the way, if you consider that this tutorial is helpful and useful for others, please hit the like button and comment your opinion in the comment section. Thank you for liking and supporting us. Before implementing hydrated block, let's wrap up what we have done until this time, in this part. So, here in the main, the app changes its theme according to switch value. If switch value is true, that means it calls the dark theme. Otherwise, light theme. So, here in the app theme, dark mode mostly contains black and gray colors. And in the my drawer, When a user changes its state and turns it on, that means switch value will be true. Then switch on event is added and dark theme is set in the app. So, how to restart? And the theme came back to initial light mode. Let's implement hydrated block. Go to switch state, put the mouse cursor on the class name and press Ctrl plus dot and select JSON serialization. Delay dart convert and from JSON into JSON. And go to switch block. And type the word hydrated here. Import block exports. And create hydrated block overrides. And as always, return here switch state dot from map. And here return state dot to map. That's all. Let's test it. Change app theme in dark mode. Hot restart and wait. And it didn't go back to initial light mode. Now, quit the app and reopen it. Still dark theme. Congratulations, it's all working perfect. That's all for this part. Thank you for watching. See you in the next part.